What town do you live in?
Massachusetts.
Welcome. So, where are you from, young man?
Systems and weaponry upgrades came as well. Doctrine also involved that gave tanks a greater role as a major maneuver warfare asset, including the use as mobile artillery support, a replacement for the traditional horse cavalry and combat engineering roles. Before the U.S. entered World War II, large-scale blind arm exercises in Canada. Actually called the
Bradley, Dwight Eisenhower, and George Patton. Meanwhile, American allies and foes were not idle in tank development, production, or doctrine. They were producing very capable tanks, most notably Germany and the Soviet Union, as well as the United Kingdom, France, and others. Early in the war, the U.S. relied on its light tank, the M2 series. They were light, maneuverable, but poorly armored. Some were employed in the Battle of Guadalcanal in 1943, where the Japanese also fielded some light tanks. But a more capable replacement had been sought early in the war. That replacement came in 1942 and was named the medium tank, also known as the M4. The M4 Sherman was now on the ground. That is the M4 Sherman. Interestingly, it was the British who first dubbed it.
That's the M24.
Yep, that's the Chaffee.
M24 Chaffee. So you see the Chaffee is slightly smaller than the Sherman medium tank. The Chaffee, that was considered a light tank, right?
Very, that's the light tank. And it's used by the United States and 28 other operators throughout the world. And also, apart from being in the she was actually produced and came into production 1944 right through to 1953. She was actually used, of course, World War II, Korean War, First Indochina War, and the Vietnam War as well, and the Soviet War, the Algerian War, and the Indo-Pakistani War of 1971.
How many of the M24 Chaffees were manufactured?
There was 4,731.
Wow. And the Chaffee also took a crew of five, right? Relatively cheap to produce and available in great numbers. It was also the basis of several successful tank destroyers, such as the Achilles M10. So if you look down on the field, right next to the Stug is the Achilles M10. Also, the Sherman contributed to the development of other tanks like the M36. Tens of thousands of Shermans were distributed through the Lend-Lease program to the British Commonwealth and the Soviet Union. Again, the tank was named after William Sherman, the Civil War general. You know, it's all the variants of the Shermans. There was also the M4E2 Sherman was the first jumbo size Sherman produced. The jumbo Sherman, very rare tank, right? And we have a jumbo Sherman inside the museum.
Yeah, the back of the vault section.
Right. Now, one thing that everyone should really hang around for is gunner all the way through Europe, survived out of the vault, and pushed
on the chairs. Yeah!
I didn't mention it.
Yeah.
I'm going to go to the public. Yeah. I'm going to go to the public.
you guys.
In preparation for this weekend, we want to give a big thanks to Dick Moran and the rest of the crew out there for getting everything greased and ready to go. For about every hour of operation that these tanks go through, we put them through about 4 hours of maintenance. They go through quite a bit of fuel, they take some knowledge to keep these tanks operating.
It does, especially at this period, because these are all the early designs of gasoline engines, and that, so it's all the old days, sparks and plugs, and it's a big juggling. It's been interesting over the last few years when we picked up this collection in California. Dick and I were down in California putting this whole collection together, and that's been quite completely put together, the remarkable group of guys, all volunteers, many of them are former service and veterans. So thank you guys for your service and your service to
Stearman's. What's interesting is the PT-17 Stearman, at least one of them over there, is the last remaining Stearman that originally trained Tuskegee Airmen during World War II. So it's a really fascinating collection over in the hangar. And in the classic car barn, there's some real beauties from early American, kind of the classic automobile era. So we have a Fred Duesenberg, a Rolls Royce that was actually manufactured in Springfield, Massachusetts in 1927. And some Cords and other really beautiful cars. We'll be pulling them out in June, right, Colin, for the American Elegance performance. So that's a lot of fun to see. If you come back over Father's Day weekend, we put on a real fun show and operate all the classic cars. So, Colin,
they've done a fantastic job on that. It's well done to them. And this is their first full weekend. This weekend they are up with you. So, hopefully keep it running, keep it good. But, well done. Thank you.
Greg.
this one sounds.
But it's louder.
But the ears sound thin.
That's pretty cool.
They said 600.
No, for a half a turn.
Oh, right.
Then I'm done.
If you break it down. Oh, look, Mr. T.